All right, y'all, this is going to be lesson 1-1 for geometry. It's called Nets and Drawings for Visualizing Geometry. So, our purpose here today, or our objective, is to make nets and drawings of 3D figures. Okay. The essential understanding says you can represent a three-dimensional or a 3D object with a two-dimensional figure using special drawing techniques, which we'll go over today. A net is a two-dimensional diagram that you can fold to form a three-dimensional figure. A net shows all of the surfaces of a figure in one view. So, for instance, if you have some sort of triangular pyramid, this is one way I can represent a three-dimensional pyramid on a two-dimensional piece of paper. Okay, or maybe a cube. This is a way I can draw a three-dimensional cube on a two-dimensional sheet of paper. So what we're going to do is a cube actually has six surfaces. So if you were to unfold this box, it could look something like that to show the six surfaces. So let's look at problem one. It says the net at the right, so this is the net, folds into the cube. Imagine folding this to form this shape. Okay. It says which letter will be on the top and front of the cube. So on the right side, that's D. So the only way I could do that is if I were to fold D on its side. Okay, and then I would fold B, and B would be the left side, and A would be on the back. All right, what's right next to D here is C. Okay, so this face would be C. All right, and how do we get the top? The top face of the cube, or the top surface, would be E. So there, the top would be C, or excuse me, no, it's not. The top is E. And the front face is C. Okay, that's the front face, that's E. Okay, they're not really asking me for it, okay, but the left side, even though we can't see it on this diagram, the left face would be B, and the back would be A, and the bottom would be F, based on this net, the way they've labeled this net. All right, so when we get to the got it problems, I want you to read it, pause the video and read it, and try it for yourself, and then when you think you've got it, hit play and see if you get the right answer. So it says the net in problem one, so I'm going to redraw the net from problem one. Okay, the net in problem one folds into this cube, and it shows me the cube now has a front face at B. Okay, so that's the front face right there. Which letters will be on the top and the right side? So how can I fold this stuff around to make this box? Well, here's B. Right next to B, to the right of B, is C. Okay, so C is now on the right. Then after you fold C around, you would fold E down on top. Okay, so here E is on top. Okay. Now, if we kept going around, not that they're asking me to, but I could also fold this F back over so F is still on the bottom. Okay. On the left is A. And in the back would be D. Okay, so it's basically just taking this cube and rotating it, really. That's all that's different. Okay, let's look at problem two. It says, packaging designers use nets to design boxes and other containers like the box in problem two. Okay, so this box of graham crackers, let's read the question. It says, package design. What is a net for the graham cracker box to the right? And label the net with its dimensions. Okay, so let's start with what we see. Okay, here's the front right here. All right, so what dimensions does that front of the box have? Well, it has a height of 20 and a length of 14. All right, so that's 14 there, and that's 20. Okay, what would the right side, where's the right side of this box? Okay, the right side of this box is right here. Okay, what dimensions does it have? It also, this is 20 right here, so is this. This is also 20, and it should be 20 because if I were to unfold this box, then I get this right side here. Okay, so it also has a height of 20, but now that's going to be the width. That's only 6. Even though we can't see the left side has to be the same as the right side, otherwise the box wouldn't fold correctly. Okay, so there's 20 and 6 again. And even though we can't see the back has got to have the same dimensions as the front. So that's another 20 by 14. So I'm just going to put this off to the other side. Right, 20, 14. And basically this is really just one line. Okay, I'm just drawing it in there again. Okay, so if we want to think about it, this is the front as we look at it. This side is the back, even though we can't see it. This is the right side of the box. That's the left side of the box. Now, what about the top of the box? Here's the top of the box. You want to think about those dimensions, okay, it's 14, has a length of 14, and it has a width of 6. So it has the same length as the front, but when I unfold it, it's going to have a width of 6. So there's 6 and there's 14. That's the top part of the box. And then the bottom is going to be the same thing. Okay, it's going to be 14 here and 6 there. Now, if I were to refold this diagram, that's how I get the box. This is the bottom. Okay, so why is this even necessary? Why do we have to use these nets? Well, here, if I think about the area of each face, I can figure out what the surface area of this box is, how much material I need, by adding up the individual areas of these 6 faces of the three-dimensional figure. So that's why it's useful. Okay, so pause the video and try got it too. Okay, and just try to do one part at a time. Try to do one part at a time. All right. So what I see here on the bottom of this figure, it looks like some sort of rectangle. And that rectangle has a length of 7 and a width of 4. imagine, let me do it right here. Imagine cutting right here along this edge now. Okay? Imagine making cuts there. What's going to happen to this? It's going to fall down to the right side of the green. So when that falls down, guess what? It's another rectangle. All right? It's going to have 4 as a width, and that's going to be a little bit longer. That's going to be 10 centimeters. So that's 4, and that's 10. Now if you cut along this back edge, okay, you're going to have this other, you're going to have the left side. So you're going to have another one of these rectangles. All right, so that's going to be 10 and that's going to be 4. But we have 2 more shapes actually. When I cut along those lines, if I have a scissors, this part's going to fall down. And that part's a triangle. And that part is a triangle. And that's going to fall towards me. It's going to fall down towards me. Okay? That's going to be right next to the green shape. So that part's 7. That's this part. And then it has a slant height of 10. And when I cut this other piece, then we have another triangle, you know, up there. So we can put that up here. All right. So this particular diagram has 5 faces. It has this one, right? You have 2 triangles. So I have 2 triangles right here and here. Okay, you got these 2 rectangles that we have to fold up to get there, so that's these 2. And then you have the base of the object, which is right there. Okay? Hopefully that makes some sense. All right, so how do we even do this drawing that we saw here? This is a 3D drawing. This is a 3D drawing. So how do we make these 3D drawings? Well, these 3D drawings have a special name. They're called isometric drawings. Okay, it shows a corner view of a 3-dimensional figure. It allows you to see the top, that's this part, the front, that's this part, and the side of a figure, so one of the sides. You can draw an isometric drawing on special kind of paper, which are called isometric dot paper. So what's special about isometric dot paper is it has rows of dots, but every other row is offset a little bit. So like this dot right here is halfway in between those two. This dot is halfway in between those two. So on and so forth. All right, so even when I make a cube, if I'm going to try to draw a cube, and if I want to make a cube that looks like it's 3-dimensional, okay, I have to kind of put it at a slant. Okay, I have to do that so it looks more 3D. All right. So the difference between this is an isometric drawing, all right, so it's basically a 3D rendering or a 3D picture on a 2D surface, like a piece of paper. That's different from a net, because net shows how this thing folds out. And these slanted lines that we use represent how deep the object goes back. So let's do a practice problem. Okay. So let's practice drawing this thing using an isometric drawing. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm just basically going to copy it as it exists. So I'm going to imagine this yellow cube here has a length of 1. And as I can see, this line is straight down. So if I start my picture here, I want to make a line straight down to represent that. Now this line is slanted. So I will need to make a slanted line. So I'm going to go from this dot, and I'm going to take it down till it hits this dot. So it's a little bit slanted. And then straight line up. So there's my straight line up, and then another slanted line. So there's a slanted line. All right, if I do this line, that's a slanted line. So I'm going to take that up to here. Okay. Then a line straight up, 1 unit. Okay. So there's 1 unit, a slanted line. All right, and then I have a slanted line and another slanted line. Slanted line, slanted line. And I can do exactly the same thing with these other two pictures. So on the blue over here, I just see the front face. And that's right underneath the front face of this red. So I'm gonna take the front face of this red over here, and I'm just gonna basically duplicate that part of it. Okay. So that's this part I just drew. All right. Now to make this green cube, okay, I need to continue down. All right, so I'm going to continue down, straight line up, so straight line up, slanted line, all right, slanted line, slanted line. Slanted line, line straight down. Okay. And then slanted line. So there we go. There is an isometric drawing. So it looks like it's three cubes. Okay. It looks like that object is three-dimensional now, even though it's sitting on a two-dimensional piece of paper. So go ahead and pause the video and try to make this, all right, draw this as an isometric drawing on the isometric dot paper. Pause it and then see if you did it correctly. All right, so you can do it one piece at a time. All right, so I can make that line. All right, actually, let me just show you one face at a time. So there's that face. Okay, then I can make that one. And then I can finish that out. Then I can make this one. I probably should have started this a little bit lower. All right, I have to imagine where this is going to be. I can make this line. I have to make this line. Okay. I can make that line and that line. And then this line. All right, and if I had more dots up above, I could do this one. But here's what it would be. If there was another dot up there. Just imagine there's another dot up there. can make that line, this line, and that line. Make this line, this line. Make that line and that line. So there we go. There's your cube stacked on top of each other. And hopefully you understand underneath this cube, there's got to be another cube beneath that to support it. That's why there's that second level on there. All right. So those are isometric drawings. Now we're going to learn about a different type of drawing, which is an orthographic drawing. Okay. This is another way to represent a three-dimensional figure. An orthographic drawing shows three separate views, a top view, a front view, and a right side view. Okay, so if I was looking at this cube, let me draw this isometrically first. Okay. All right, if that's my isometric drawing, how do I change that into an orthographic drawing? Well, if I was looking at this cube straight on, okay, straight on, then I would only see a square as the front face. All right, so I would show that as the front face. If I was looking directly on top of the cube, then I would see a square on the top. All right, so I would only draw a square on the top. And if I looked at it from the right side, I would see this face, but I wouldn't see anything else, which is another square. All right, so it's taking a look at an object from three different views. All right, and this is what architects do. They draw this so when you think about everything you're looking at, you can take these three pictures and understand what it looks like in three dimensions. Okay, it looks like a square when I'm looking straight down. It looks like a square when I'm looking at it from the front. It looks like a square when I'm looking at it from the right. Okay, so the only way that works is if it's a cube. Okay, so how do you do an orthographic drawing? Well, you have to think about how you're looking at this object. This right here, this is the isometric version of the drawing, but we want to change that into an orthographic drawing. So if I look at this from the front, what would I see? I would see this face, but I wouldn't see this face, all right? I would only see that face if I was looking at it from the right. I wouldn't see this top piece. So the only things I would see is that when I'm looking at this, assuming everything is square and 90 degrees, I would only see this part and this part, and I wouldn't see any other part of the diagram. So what is this shape? Well, it's a rectangle. It's 1, 2, 3 units high and 1 unit wide. All right, so it's 1 unit wide and 1, 2, 3 units high. So I would see that part, and the part that's right next to it, I go over one, up and up one from the ground. So it's just a 1 by 1 square. So that's what I would see if I just looked at it face on, at no angle. Okay, so I'm not going to see any. I'm not going to see any angles. I'm going to look at it face on. So the only thing I'm seeing is that and this. All right. If I look at the picture straight from the top at no angle, the only thing I'm going to see is I'm going to see this little square, and I'm going to see this back part that looks like an L. Okay. So I'm going to see a square. All right, and it's 1 unit by 1 unit. Then I'm gonna see this L. Well, this L comes one more to the right from there, okay, but it's offset a little bit. All right, then it goes basically up a unit. All right, then over a unit. up another unit, then over a unit. And even though we can't see it in the back, we're assuming this will come all the way back down. Okay, so here's the square that I see from this part, and then here's the L that we see. So those would be the only surfaces we see from looking down from the top. Now, if I'm looking at this from the right, what would I see? I would see this face, which looks like a rectangle. So let's start to draw that. All right, it's 3 units high. It's 1 unit deep, so I would definitely see that. Okay. I would also see this square when I look at it from the right. Okay. And then there's also this other little square in the back that I would also see. And it's the same height as this first square. Okay, it's on the lower level. So there we go. This would be the orthographic drawing. Okay, and if you think about each of these views, if you put these 3 views together, someone could make this picture. Okay, if you put these 3 views together, and think about how it fits together, you can make that diagram. Just takes time and practice. All right, so pause the video and try to make an orthographic drawing, so a front view, a top view, and a side view for this. When you think you've got it, play the video. So if I want to think about the front faces, I'm going to see that square. Okay, and I'm also going to see this part. This part goes 2 to the right of the initial square. Okay, it goes 2 units up. Okay, then it would come 2 back to the left. It would go 1 up, 1 to the left, and 2 down. All right. And this orthographic paper, just standard dots, no offset dots. So that's what it would look like if I was looking at it straight on from the front. Now, what about the top? Okay, if I'm looking at it on the top, I see this square. So we'll start with that. It's a 1x1 square. Okay, I also would see this square, which is a 1x1 square, and it would look like they're right next to each other, because if I'm looking straight from the top, I can't judge any type of depth. So there's a 1x1 square. All right. And then I also see this rectangle, and this rectangle is 2 units and 1 unit. Okay. So it would go 2 units left to right and 1 unit down. So that's what I would see if I was looking down from the top. If I was looking at it from the right, I would see this square face furthest to the left. Okay, I would see this rectangular face. All right, it's 1 unit wide and it's 2 units high. So 1 unit wide, 2 units high. Okay, and then I would also see this square face. Okay, but I wouldn't see the depth here. I would only see that from the top. So putting these 3 diagrams together, kind of gives you an idea for the shape and the depth of this figure. That's why we have to do three drawings to get shape and depth. So that's the correct orthographic drawing for this figure. All right. And that's going to do it. So hopefully you learned some things. Just bring these skills into class with you tomorrow and we'll work problems together. So thank you for watching.